During the making of all performances by the different classes of LSPR communication faculty, students observe strict regulations in compliance with COVID-19 mandatory health protocols imposed by the government of Indonesia.
Department of Performing Art Communications at LSPR Communication and Business Institute proudly present the 17th LSPR PAC Festival and its 27th LSPR Theatre Festival. The first LSPR Performing Art Communication Festival was held in January 2014 by Performing Art Communication student, and LSPR Theatre Festival is in 2005 by Batch 7 from student of Mass Communications Department. By year 2022, LSPR Theatre Festival had already held 358 theater festival production. We have run 36 online performance and LSPR performing art and one acting museum, 4 dance concert, 5 monologue festival and 1 duologue festival and 4 costume exhibition and 7 books of short stories and monologue script and 23 music concert and 24 theater performance. In the year 2008, LSPR Jakarta received a prestigious award from Indonesian Guinness Book of Records or MURI for holding the longest theater production for the 4th LSPR Theater Festival. In the year 2015, another award from Indonesian Guinness Book of Records or MURI was received by LSPR Jakarta for PAC performance for having an acting museum as the first acting museum in Indonesia. The 27th LSPR Theatre Festival will present Batch 25 or the first year student as their academic requirement and for the subject Introduction to Performing Art. Through the subjects and the holding of each theatre festival and PAC festival, students were taught how to communicate through performing arts. We believe that every performance on stage is a communication activity which tell us about life in the form of arts. Like William Bennett said, the arts are the essential element of education, just like reading, writing, arithmetic, music, dance, painting, theater, and all keys that unlock profound human understanding and accomplishment. To all participants of Batch 23, 24 and Batch 25 student, I say do your best and be proud of your class performance because you are LSPR pride. Thank you and good luck for your performance, and wish you all have an enjoyable study at LSPR. Sampai jumpa!
Thank you. every parents always say, we are born in this world with a pure heart. So we just need to do good things. Just good things in life. So we will be more productive and worthwhile. We will turn out to become like really good people, like an angel. We know that it's impossible to become like they want to, or what they think about ourselves. We are full of secrets.
Susie, I think she needs to stop right now. They study different attacks.
Everybody except our parents just want to know our good behaviors, our talents. And we can get applause if we get achievement. Anyways, the question is, how can we do that?
Just stop it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very sorry for the misunderstanding. We'll get back to the real reason why we are here for this celebration. Thank you. So now, please give applause for the next performance.
Go fast. We all run out of time. You should prepare your presentation this morning, so you just need to present right now.
Hey, I lost my lighter.
What? How did you lose those things?
I don't know.
We could be in trouble if the teacher found. Go search. Maybe you just had forgot where you put the lighter.
Come on, Austin's group. Still a long time. Do you need more time?
Can you just wait for us? We are still searching the file. I forgot where I put the file.
Okay. While we're waiting for your group to find it, I will discuss this. I know that you will graduate soon, but one thing you must know is that you must obey all of the rules in this school. When you are in this school, you need to obey all rules. Don't follow behavior like this group, no preparation at all. They're wasting time with their carelessness. Now, Ethan, you can go first to your presentation because I'm sure that you have already prepared it. I can see from your face.
Thank you, ma'am.
Down, I don't wanna pull through. I look over your photograph and I think how much I miss you. I miss you. I wish I knew where I was, cause I don't have a clue. I just need to work out some way of getting me to you. Cause I will never find love like ours out here.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good job, Ethan. It's a very wonderful song. You bring the song very well so that we can get the message from that song. I'm very sure you will be a successful person in the future.
Ooh, looking for attention.
I'm sorry, Martin. What are you talking about? Please keep your words good. Ethan is capable of doing this exercise. We can see from his achievement that he has already shown us. I wish that everyone here can show yourself with your own achievement, which are what your accomplishment will be based on. Now, Martin's group, it's your turn.
Let's go, guys.
Let's go.
Come on, come on. Woo!
you to know that I'm never leaving, cause I'm Mr. Snow, till that will be freezing. Yeah, you are my home for my season. So come on, let's go below zero and hide from the sun. I love you forever, then we'll have some fun. Let's hit the dark corners, have happily. Please don't cry, no tears now, it's Christmas, baby. My snowman.
Give applause, guys.
Good job. Thank you for your performance. I hope in the future your group project can be finished on time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, let's finish this class. Thank you for today. See
Thank
you in the next week.
Thank you, Miss.
What now?
Let's go. This is your break, bro.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey, C. Is this real? My letter is Ethan's back. I think Ethan is a nice guy. I don't know if he smokes anyway.
Come on, guys. You cannot know people from their appearance. Come on.
But I think we must give him some advice, maybe.
Sure. I agree.
Let's go.
Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Sorry to interrupt. I came here just because I just want to talk about all of your whole progress in this semester. Because you might already know that we don't have much time until you are our graduate, right? So keep it up. Phoebe, how's your progress?
It's great, ma'am.
Cool. Okay. How about you, Daisy?
Is it good, ma'am?
Great. And the others?
Ma'am.
How?
May I go to the toilet, please?
Of course, Ethan.
Thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am. May I go to the toilet?
Sure, yes.
Thank you.
Me too, ma'am.
Yeah, okay.
May I go to the toilet, ma'am?
Sure. Go on.
I don't know, but I just feel there is something wrong. Phoebe, how is your score? Is it good?
No, just C. How about you?
Just B.
And Ethan?
Don't ask him. The perfect guy in this school, of course, A+.
Is it possible for Ethan to get C? Because I've learned from Ethan's note, but my score is still stuck in C.
Maybe there is problem in your brain?
Shut up! Hey, where do you want to go?
Canteen. Do you want to go with me?
No. But buy a meat star will make for me. Okay? Please?
Okay.
Why are you back?
I forgot to bring my wallet.
Ah, you're just like my grandma.
Are you smoking in school? You know about the rules, right?
Yeah. So, what's wrong? Do you want some?
No.
Hey, don't fool yourself. I know you are smoking. Alright, sit down.
Hey. Calm down. Just calm down. I get this from your bag. Let me think about it. If you're not smoking, so what is this for?
Or maybe you're like Daphne?
This letter belongs to Daphne.
Stop, stop. I don't understand about it. And let me go.
Sit down. Just calm, okay? Just calm. Okay. If you don't want to tell us the truth, I think I can show you how to become
what
a good person.
Phoebe, I want to talk something with you.
What happened? You look so serious. Are you doing something wrong?
Hey guys, I think I will go on first because there is so many assignments that I must do. Okay, see you later.
Guess after.
Wait, what happened to your hand?
Oh, this hand, you mean it's nothing. I just didn't pay attention.
Okay.
Okay, I will go on first.
Get well soon.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.
What are you doing?
What are you talking about?
A lighter.
Lighter? What lighter?
Daphne's lighter.
Hey, I don't know what you are talking about. Daphne smokes? I don't care.
Hey, I saw it. You put Daphne's lighter in Ethan's bag. I saw you had taken Daphne's letter and put it into Ethan's bag.
Hey, Daisy, listen. I don't know what you are talking about and I have so many things to do. I will go home first, yeah? Bye. I'm home.
Hey, Mommy's waiting for you.
Why?
I don't know.
Mom? Why?
Sit. Okay, I'll fix it. Thank you. Do you know how much I spent on your education? I do not hope that you can get the scholarship. Just please, get a good score. What is it? Is it the score? Huh? I cannot read it. The bad. Can you learn from Ethan? You're the bestie, right? Just learn from him. I heard he got a scholarship for this semester. How about you?
What's
your role? Your dad? Be kind to your sister. How? How can you fix it?
I try my best.
Okay, let's make an agreement. You must get the scholarship next semester. If Ethan can do it, you can do it too. Try to find out how he learns and the method how he study. If next semester you can get the scholarship, so you pay for your own school fee. Frankly speaking, I'm so tired with your score until this time. I always try my best to earn more and more money to pay for your school. See, what have you given to me until now? Nothing.
Okay. Come in.
Good morning.
Morning.
What did I tell to you? Stop smoking. It's not good for your health.
You know what? This is my medicine. I got a lot of stress in my home.
About what?
About you.
About me?
Forgetting. Anyway, how is your homework? Can I see it? Because I haven't done it.
No, I don't want to share this. You must do more exercise so you can do your homework with your own ability.
So stingy.
Ooh. Hi.
Hey guys, good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Where are you? I'm waiting for you in front of the school gate.
I'm still in Phoebe's house.
Oh, okay. I'll go first to class. See you in class.
See you in class, Dais.
See you.
Excuse me, ma'am. Can I get in?
Oh, Daisy. Yes, of course. Come on in, darling. Please have a seat. So, Daisy, what's bring you here?
I want to report something, ma'am. It happened to my friend.
Something? Is it something bad? You can tell me about it.
My friend, Ethan, he got an accident. He got violence from Martin and the gang.
Can you tell me who are they?
There are Martin, Austin, and Daphne. I know that Daphne wasn't there in the warehouse when it happened, but I'm very sure Daphne know about this. I heard everything. I saw the scar they made on Ethan.
Hey, Daisy, look. Calm down. Everything's gonna be fine. You can trust me and I'll solve this problem, okay?
Okay, ma'am, but can I ask for one thing?
Yes, of course. What is it?
I just want to help Ethan. So, can you keep secret about me? Who is telling about this accident?
Yes, obviously. I will not tell anyone anything about this accident. And also, thank you for giving me this information. I'll help you by giving a punishment to the student who makes this problem.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am.
No worries.
Okay, students, open your book, page 39.
Good morning.
Good morning, Miss.
Good morning, Miss.
I got a report from one of the students at the school that there was an incident of violence to another student. Austin, Martin, and Daphne, follow me.
Damn, Ethan! You're really making us this problem with me! Hey!
Oh my god.
Hey, do you see Ethan?
I don't know.
How about you? Do you see Ethan?
No, I didn't see him.
How about you guys? Anyone see Ethan? Where do you wanna go? Alright, bye-bye!
Okay, I found the solution. So, Daphne, bring Ethan for us. We will be waiting in the same place like before. You understand?
Okay.
Alright. Find him.
Okay. Okay. Are we ready?
Let's go.
Let's go.
She's in pain. She don't want her parents know about it. Go. Come in.
Okay. Okay. Where's the baby?
Hey, big mouth. I got you now.
Are you talking to me? Where is Phoebe? Daphne, did you lie to me?
How dare you report us to the principal?
What are you talking about? And where is Phoebe?
She's not here. You fool.
Bro, you really did the wrong thing. Martin is already on fire, dude.
What are you talking about? Can you explain to me what happened?
We know that you talked to the principal about accident in the warehouse.
Wait, me? No, I didn't report it.
Big mouth, repeat again what you have talked about. Daphne, watch around and guard the doors and don't let any teacher see us.
Okay,
I
want
to play with this guy and teach him a lesson not to be a terrible person.
Yes, bro. Enough, Art.
Go.
Ethan! Ethan, what happened? Are you okay? Ethan! Phoebe, come in and help us! I'll help you to the class.
Thank you.
Be careful.
Hey, I think I have to go to the toilet first because...
Are you sure?
Yeah, I have to tie down my uniform.
Okay.
Thank you. See you in class.
See you in class, Ethan. unusual you careless to think you like Ethan.
Good afternoon, class.
Good afternoon, ma'am. What? What happened?
Hey, do you see my watch?
No, I didn't see.
Do you see my watch? Hey, do you see my watch? Anybody? Do you see my watch? Where's my watch?
Do you still remember where you...
Where is my watch? Did someone in this class took my watch? Why are you not answering me? Tell me, who is taking my watch? No one knows about it?
Martin, enough. Don't be angry like that. Ask nicely to your friends.
I apologize if I bothered you, but I'm pretty sure that someone in this class took my watch.
Bro, just chill and check out Ethan's bag. Maybe what are you looking for is in there.
You're right. Ethan took my watch.
But I didn't take it. I didn't know why Martin's watch was in my bag.
Martin, it's not good accusing your friends like that.
Then what is this? This is proof. Proof that Ethan is in the thief in this class.
Hey, calm down. I don't even know what's happening. And you suddenly accuse me of being a thief? Martin, I was even late for class. Then how can I take your watch? You know, right? What's the reason for bringing me late to go to class?
Okay, calm down, calm down. If Ethan did it, we can directly report to the principal. Now, Ethan, try to be honest with me. Is it true that you took Martin's watch?
No, I wouldn't dare to do that.
Okay, I believe you, Ethan. Maybe it's just a misunderstanding.
You're so lucky this time, Ethan. Really lucky this time.
Chill, bro.
Hey, you're the person who took Martin's watch in Ethan's bag. That's right?
Yeah, but I don't know. The watch doesn't belong to Ethan.
Then why didn't you explain it to the English teacher?
I don't want to do that. If I'm being honest, my reputation will be bad.
Oh, so you put your reputation first beside your honesty?
Ma'am, can I go to the toilet, please?
Sure, Daisy.
Thank you, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am. Can I go to the toilet, please?
Sure, Phoebe.
Thank you.
Hey! I know that you steal my watch.
I didn't steal your watch.
Then what is that? I found that in your bag.
I don't even know what's happening.
You want to fight again with me, huh?
Go, go.
Why is this class so noisy? Sorry, ma'am. These kids are making a fuss over who stole Martin's watch.
And then who took Martin's watch?
Ethan's, ma'am.
Okay, now, Ethan, follow me.
Okay, ma'am.
Ethan!
I don't know how to say it, but...
I'll be waiting for him in my room after this.
Please.
Yes, ma'am.
Be careful.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ethan, please come in. Ethan, your friends talking about you. Can you guess what are they talking about?
No, ma'am.
Ethan, I always thought you were a good boy, but now you're disappointing me.
But I didn't steal Martin's
what
watch.
What are you talking about?
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I'm honest that I didn't steal Martin's watch.
What about the kleptomaniac then?
What are you talking about?
Oh, come on, Ethan, I know about all of your secret.
Secret? What a secret?
I heard it from your lovely friends, Daisy and Phoebe. I heard they talk together in the restroom when I was walking to your class.
Yeah, about you. I saw it when you put Daphne's lighter into Ethan's bag. Are you really purposely doing that to Ethan? I just don't know about your mind. Ethan is your best friend, right?
Hey, enough. First, I don't know if the lighter belongs to Daphne. And second, a secret that I want to tell you, it's not about me. It's about Ethan. Maybe you don't know about this, because we have been friends since senior high school, right? But not for Ethan. I've known Ethan since junior high school, and I know about his secret. He is a kleptomaniac. That's the reason why all of his stuff has black color.
Yes, I am a kleptomaniac. So what?
Do you know what I hate, Ethan?
Yeah, I think you hate students who don't obey the rules. I know, I made a mistake. But have you ever thought that everyone has their own secret? And people like you always think that a student who has a good achievement is perfect. It's wrong, by the way. Same as what you are doing to me right now. This is so scary seeing your behavior towards about me, about this problem. I can see from your face. You have secrets too, right?
Yes, that is correct. But I don't want our school to have a bad reputation just because you like to steal things from your friends.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I promise I won't do it again.
But you broke it, Ethan.
Then what should I do?
Oh, you don't have to do anything, but instead, I have to do something.
What is that?
I will get rid of you.
Just do it then.
This is weird. How much time does Ethan need to talk with the principal? It's already 2 hours.
Or has he already gone home?
No, he has not. I know him so well.
Try to call him.
Okay. What if we go to the principal room and ask the principal about Ethan?
Okay, it's a good idea.
Let's go. Hurry up.
Let's go.
Hey, it's not locked.
Come in. Maybe Ethan fell asleep in here? Haha, just kidding.
Yeah, and you mean the principal felt pity for him to wake him up? So funny. Oh my god, it's so dark in here. Can you turn on the light? I can't see anything.
No. If we turn on the light, we will count by security.
Daisy!
just use your phone's light.
Oh my god, you're smart. I think Ethan has gone back to his house. No one's here.
Interesting.
Oh my god, what you're doing? Daisy, let's go home.
No. Are you not curious about the exams question?
No. Let's go home now.
No.
Daisy,
Phoebe, there is something wrong in this cupboard.
What? I can't see anything.
Wait.
Daisy, what you doing? Don't do stupid things. Let's go home.
No.
Oh my.
Can you help me to move the cupboard? Please. Oh my god.
What's that?
I don't. Look!
Hold yourself. If you scream, we'll be suspect. I don't want to make ourselves a problem. I've sent message to the police. Now, we get out from here. Let's go. Hurry up.
Hello. I'm sorry to interrupt you tonight. Are you Ethan's parents? Chris Ethan from Royal King High School.
Why? Who is this?
I'm a policeman. So around 6 o'clock, our office got a call. When we talked with the caller, there's no response. So we asked her to send message for us. When we got the location, we found the suspected corpse was Ethan. His body is being examined in forensics.
What? Okay, send me the location now.
Phoebe, are you okay? What happened? Tell me, Maria. What happened? Daphne. Phoebe.
My god, what happened? What is it?
We found this in your room.
What? Seriously, I don't know about that. I didn't lock my door, so maybe other people entered it and did that.
Okay, so right now you can follow me to be a witness.
Wow, what a great performance, right? Look at that, our lovely and beloved students. Now, we'll move on to the next session. There will be speech by our favorite teacher.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Excuse me, we're from New York Police Department. Are you Miss Suzanne?
Yes, I am. What's your business?
So, good morning, ma'am. We are the police who have been investigating Ethan's case. We found this in your room when we were searched comprehensively in the school.
My room? No. I don't understand what you're talking about, so please get out or
else. No. You must follow us to go to the police right now.
Why would I? You don't even have the warrant.
No, we have warrant. You have the right to be silent or obtain legal assistance.
You can do
and
this to me. You don't even
legal
have
law.
Enough
so right
evidence.
Now, ma'am, please
let
follow
me
us. Go to the police.
No.
Let's go. So,
let me go.
Too fast.
be legal.
So right now, please follow us.
Don't follow.